Hello everyone, my name is Frederick Shimali and I'm from Technical Newstead. Technical Newstead is a technical website that posts tutorials and blogs. In this article, I will teach you about Python Enumerate function.
Most of the newcomers and even some advanced programmers are unaware of the built-in function Enumerate. In this article, we will cover the following. What is Python Enumerate? Can you enumerate a string in Python? What does enumerate mean in programming? Why enumeration is used in Python? What is the difference between enumerate and list? And what does the function enumerate do when applied on a Python dictionary? So, what is Python enumerate? A lot of times when dealing with iterators, you might need to keep account of iterations. Python provides a built-in function, enumerate, for this task. Enumerate method adds a counter to a collection, like tuple or array, and returns it in a form of enumerate object. This enumerate object can then be used directly in for loops or be converted into a list of tuples using list method. The enumerate function adds a counter as the key of the enumerate object. So the syntax is we write enumerate and then between parentheses the iterable, which is a sequence, an iterator, or an object that supports iteration. And then start, which is the starting index of our counter. What does enumerate mean in programming? In this example, we create a list called myList that contains four strings. Then a for loop iterates over the enumerate object created from this list. In every iteration, counter is the index of value that corresponds to every element of the array. When running the script, the following result is displayed: 0 France, 1 Italy, and it goes on. So now, if we add the second argument, enumerate my list will become enumerate my list, 3, and the index will start from 3 instead of 0. So we declare the array my list that contains 4 names of countries, and then a for loop iterates over the enumerate object. The result displayed is 3 France, 4 Italy, and it goes on. So now we start from 3, not from 0. We can use the optional argument of enumerate when creating tuples, containing the index and list them using a list. Here is an example. So we have an old list that contains the same 4 countries and then a new list. This new list is declared based on a list of an enumerate object and then we print it. So we got a tuple. So now we got an array containing tuples. So now an example using tuple. As mentioned above, you can enumerate over a tuple as well, since tuples are iterable objects. Doing so is very similar to enumerating over a list. So we have a tuple called countries that contains 4 countries, and then we do the same as 4 arrays, and we will have the same results. Why enumeration is used in Python? The enumerate function in Python is commonly used instead of the for loop. That's because enumerate can iterate over the index of an item, as well as the item itself. Using enumerate also makes the code cleaner, since you have to write fewer lines. For example, using the for loop to do the same thing as this example, it would look something like this. So we have the first example that is declaring an array and then printing this list of countries with an index. And the same is achieved using the for loop, but it is a lot bigger and longer. And both of them display the same result. In Python, strings are iterable. That means you can use enumerate the same way you would with any other iterable object. In this example, we have a string called str, its value is it works. And then we printed the enumerate object using a list. So the following result is displayed. We have the index and then each letter alone in a tuple. Every character from the string is considered as a value and given an index. Then, when we call the print function, each character is displayed by itself. Another example using strings, we have a string called hello, and then a for loop iterates over the enumerate object. So first we declare a string named string of value hello. Using the enumerate object with an argument string, in every iteration, the index and character are stored in variables, and then displayed using the print function. And the result is the following: index is the index number and character is and then each character in hop. Enumerate list of tuples. In this example, we create a list of tuples that contains name h pair. The conventional way to enumerate the list is by using a for loop. We start by creating an array that is the list of tuples, called people. Each element of the array is a tuple that contains the name and the age of a person. The name is a string and the age is an integer. We know it's a list of tuples and not lists because every element is declared between parentheses and not brackets. Using a for loop, we iterate over the enumerate object from the people list. In every iteration, id and val are assigned the index and value of each element, respectively. The val variable is a tuple, and to access elements from this tuple, we need to use brackets. And between them, which element we need. In our case, val 0 is the name and val 1 is the age. And those variables change with every iteration. Now we can simply display the result using print function. id is the counter that enumerate function creates. This will be the index. And you will get the following result. Index is 0, name is John, and age is 20. And in every iteration, those numbers and strings will change. However, a cleaner way to achieve this is through tuple unpacking. With tuple unpacking, we can do something like this. First, we declare an array people, which contains tuples, respectively the name and the age. And then inside the for loop, the first element is ID, and the second element is a tuple, not one single variable. The same result is achieved, but in a simpler way. Instead of storing the tuple in a variable in every iteration, and then reaching its elements with index 0 and 1, we can directly store the values in two separate variables using the tuple unpacking. It works because both of them are between parentheses. Now we can simply use the variables name and age in the print function. What does the function enumerate do when applied on a Python dictionary? Dictionaries and sets are not sequences. They don't have and don't need an index. And to use the enumerate function, we should care about the index, which is not the case. It doesn't make sense to enumerate over dictionaries and sets. Instead, we could iterate over the keys or values of a dictionary using the following code. We declare a dictionary called dict that contains name, surname, and age of the person. And then a for loop iterate over the items of the dictionary. K is now the key and V is the value. And now we can print it. The result is the following. Name John, surname Smith, and age 45. To iterate over a set, we declare a set that contains ABC and then a for loop can print its elements. What is the difference between enumerate and list? The list constructor returns a list. If no parameters are passed, it returns an empty list. If iterable is passed as a parameter, it creates a list consisting of the iterable's items. In this example, we print an empty list, and then a list that contains hello, and then a list that contains each character of hello above. So we get the following result. The first array is an empty array, and the second and third are similar. The list function creates an array containing each character from the passed string as an element. The same result is obtained when passing a tuple as an argument. It will be converted to an array. Now, some tasks to practice to make sure that everything we explained was clear and understood. Try to complete the following tasks and test your Python skills using the enumerate function. Create a list of grocery list and display it with an index for each item. Using the same list, add a brand for each item using a for loop. For all the items that have indexes greater than 5, remove them from the list by changing the string's value to checked. This article comes to an end here. I hope everything was clear. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to drop a comment in the sections below.